What are collinear and coplanar points? How many lines can we draw through one point? We can draw one like this, another one like this, and many more. Infinite lines can be drawn through one point. What about two points? How many lines can be drawn passing through both these points? Just one. One and only one line can be drawn passing through two given points. Now here's an interesting one. How many lines can be drawn passing through three given points? Okay, look at these three points. We cannot draw a single line passing through all three of these points. But if we have three points placed like this, where exactly one line passes through them, then the points are called collinear points. Remember, three points are collinear if exactly one line passes through each of them. Then what are these three points called? Simple, they are called non-collinear points. Collinear if one line passes through them, non-collinear if a line does not pass through them. So wait, three collinear points are special. They form a line. But what's special about three non-collinear points? Three non-collinear points form exactly one plane. If we have three non-collinear points like this, exactly one plane will pass through them. Will four or more non-collinear points always form a plane? Not necessarily, but if they do, they are called coplanar points. Understand these concepts well. Three points are collinear if exactly one line passes through them. Exactly one plane passes through three non-collinear points. And if four or more points form a plane, they are called coplanar. Coplanar is basically one plane. So when are two or more lines coplanar? Easy. If the lines lie on one plane, they are coplanar. Two or more lines lying on the same plane are called coplanar lines. When are two lines not coplanar? If two lines do not lie on the same plane like this, then they are non-coplanar. And we look at one last combination of a line and a point. Will they lie on one plane? Yes, a line and a point will always lie on a plane, exactly one plane. It doesn't matter how you position the point or the line. You can move them both as you wish. You will always have one plane passing through them.